Have you ever wondered how businesses make sense of all the data they collect? Well, it starts with data transformation, which is quite literally what it sounds like. Taking data like this and transforming it into this. In other words, something that you can actually understand. That's it. Thanks for watching. I'm just kidding. There's more to it than that. Understanding data transformation can be overwhelming since it can be explained in many ways, starting from a surface level explanation like the way I mentioned before, to heavy, deep explorations that require you to have an understanding of programming languages and best practices. Now, I get it, you're a marketer and don't want to be drowned with unnecessary information about data warehousing architectures. But my guess is you do want to understand this increasingly important concept in a simple way. So we found a happy medium to explain it. Easy to understand, yet detailed enough for you to get a good understanding of the topic. So yeah, we'll dive past the surface explanations, but don't worry, you won't need a metaphorical submarine, maybe just your favorite imaginary scuba gear. Let's go! So what is data transformation? Again, data transformation is the process of modifying data to fit a particular purpose or context. This can involve tasks such as cleaning, standardization, or aggregation, all with the goal to enhance data quality, making it easier to understand and perform more accurate analysis. Let's say you want to check your ad performance data from social media platforms like TikTok and Meta. Maybe you want to visualize the key performance metrics from the last 6 months, but when quickly viewing the raw data, you notice there are some broken cells due to missing values or incorrect data. If you were to send these raw data values to your visualization software, your final dashboard would likely be broken in one or more places. To avoid this, you need to transform the data to remove those broken values from the raw data and ensure the data is accurately sent through. Simple enough, right? We're still at surface level in our data transformation exploration though. To continue our ocean metaphor, imagine we're enjoying a nice, relaxing snorkel around a reef. Let's plunge a bit deeper. So why all the fuss about this data transformation idea? Well, it's just common sense for modern digital marketers who are running comprehensive campaigns across many different platforms, given that it's a critical step in broader, more detailed data analysis and maintenance. To effectively carry out the data transformation process, a robust data transformation tool is often required. These tools can automate many of the tasks involved in improving data quality, like cleaning and standardizing data, making the process much more efficient and less prone to error. And this comes in handy when you're working with different data from different platforms. Even Facebook and Google, two of the most popular digital advertising platforms, treat data differently. Whether it's cross-device conversions, clicks, UTM parameters, attribution, it can be extremely difficult to directly compare performance results between the two platforms using their standard raw datasets. Instead, marketers need to integrate and transform this unstructured data so that the metrics match and align. There's a reason we picked a deep sea diving metaphor to speak about data transformation. If you are experienced or have an expert guide and you are ready to dive deep, there is plenty more room to explore the topic of data transformation. For beginners, it's best to start with simple transformations and build from there. As your skills and knowledge improve, you can feel confident in exploring transformations further and deeper while creating a data transformation process that works for you. So let's take a look at the different types of transformation. In addition to some of the types we listed above, here are a few common data transformation techniques and methods: translation and data mapping, splitting, generalization, integration, discretization, manipulation. Let's go over each one. With data transformation, you're simply matching fields from one database to another, converting and aligning different fields between different databases. For example, if one database uses abbreviated country codes like these, while another spells out the country's full name, the data mapping process ensures that these fields are matched accordingly. This data mapping ensures seamless communication and consistency between databases, allowing for accurate data transfer and analysis. Splitting. If we think of our data in a spreadsheet, splitting is the process of converting a single column of data points into multiple columns. For instance, if a column consists of full URLs, splitting separates the URLs into distinct components, such as domain names and slugs. Data splitting allows for more efficient data handling and clearer presentation of information, making it easier for you to dig deeper into your data. Generalization. It's typically bad to generalize in polite conversation, but it can be useful in data transformation. It can help to simplify low-level datasets into higher-level categories that are easier to understand. One example may be simplifying the timing of customer activities throughout the day into two categories, morning and afternoon. Integration. Integration, also known as aggregation, is the process of combining data from different sources into one united view. For example, you might want to integrate your sales metrics from a brick and mortar store with those from your e-commerce platform. By integrating this data, you can get a better understanding of your operations as a whole. Discretization. While it may be a bit of a tongue twister, discretization, also known as binning, is simply the act of grouping continuous data values into discrete variables. It's commonly used by data scientists and training AI models. Discretization organizes your numbers into tidy little groups, which helps you see the bigger picture without getting lost in all the details. Manipulation. This one is pretty straightforward. Manipulation is the act of changing data to make it more legible and better organized. It can even be as simple as changing the length of decimal values. Now, there are plenty more examples than the one I just mentioned, but these are good to know from the get-go. Data transformation is a big part of why Funnel even exists. And as you can tell, we're pretty obsessed with it. Oh, maybe not obsessed, but we're really into it. I'll link our playlist here with several other videos to dive further into some of these topics. Now, if you like this video, let us know what topic you want us to cover next in the comments. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel, where you'll learn more about digital marketing, marketing data and analytics, and data visualization tips and tricks. All the great content you need to shortcut your way to being a better marketer.